Hey folks, welcome to Wolfman's Game Dent. Today we're going to unbox the game Rurik Stone and Blade, designed by Stanislav Gadonsky and published by Peacekeeper Games. Now, this is not a standalone game. It is an expansion to the game Rurik Dawn of Kiev, which is a game that I've played a few times and enjoyed quite a bit. So when the opportunity was there to back the expansion on Kickstarter, I was quite excited. There were a bunch of other extras that I picked up with that as well. I won't be covering that in this video because that relates to the base game and not the expansion itself. But in this one, we're going to crack into the expansions, Stone and Blade, and see what we have in here. Now, if I flip it over to the other side, it basically gives us a quick a flavor of what we might expect in the box. So it looks like we get new leaders that we can use in the game. We will get the ability to defeat rebel factions and accomplish new deed and agenda cards. So there's going to be a bunch of these cards that are going to pop in there as well. There are going to be a few new kind of structures you can play with. And we have the ability to capture opponents while attacking to earn greater rewards. So I haven't been through the rules for these, so I don't know exactly how they all fit in, with maybe sort of like some rudimentary understanding of what they might be, but from a component standpoint, it looks like we'll have a bunch of cards, wooden pieces, and minis in the box. So we're going to crack into it and see what we have inside. Now, from a play count point of view, it looks like it does play 1-4, so if I remember correctly, I think that's the same count that we have for the base game as well, and it is rated at 35 minutes per player. So not a short game if you're looking for a full four-player experience. So let's crack into it, take the shrink off, and see what we have inside the box. Now, this is obviously much smaller than the box size for the base game, which was much bigger, and it was more of a rectangle horizontally as opposed to sort of like this portrait format. Looking at the artwork, it is in line with the aesthetic that we saw with the base game. Overall level of detail on in here is pretty good. I'm very happy with how this looks on the box itself. So let's crack in and see what we have inside the box. Now, we get a pretty standard inside of the lid, but it does feel like a sturdy box, so let's start there. Looks like we have a storage guide, so it gives you a quick overview of how we can store some of the things in here. And I don't know if this is for the base game. I don't think it is. I think it's maybe a storage solution for the expansion box itself. So yeah, let's see what's happening in here. All right, we get the rule book and a separate book for the solo mode, so we'll see what's happening there as well. We get the overview, core components of the game comes with, setup related items, new leaders, cards, tokens, structures, and how things work. So setup, how to capture troops, releasing troops, rebel factions, setup. Yeah, so it seems like, you know, it doesn't upend how the game is played, but rather adds new components into the base game itself, and hopefully gives you a richer, fuller experience as you're playing through it. Has a bit of a reference on the back for some of the cards you'll get in here as well, which is obviously quite nice. Now, we have a book for solo mode as well. I'm not a huge solo gamer, so I'm not sure if I'll be able to get this one to the table in solo mode. In fact, I'm almost certain I probably won't. But I do obviously want to try out the multiplayer version. But if you are somebody who is into solo gaming, the good news is you do have a dedicated solo mode in this with the Rebellion setup, action phase, strategy phase, claim phase, Rebellion scoring, solo leaders, intrigue cards, epic structures, warfare, rebel faction. So it does look like there's a dedicated sort of like a set of rules for you to follow if you're playing the solo game, which suddenly makes me think like maybe it wasn't in the base game. Again, I don't remember that off of my head. Again, I wouldn't have played it solo anyway. So, great addition if you are into solo mode. So that's a good thing to know. So yeah, it looks like we got some very nice plastic inserts. We'll have a look at those in a minute. Let's maybe crack into this first and see what we have in here. I'm gonna try and do this without damaging anything as much as I can. Okay, so far so good. I think maybe we need to bring that knife in again. And off we go, right? Okay, so we have two of these. They're pretty much the same. These are punching out well enough. There's four of these, so I assume that these probably correspond to each of the individual players. From a thickness standpoint, it's not super thick, but it's all right. I guess it probably feels less thick just simply because it's a larger tile as opposed to an individual token. But overall, it's not bad. And these are fine. Although, again, it feels a little like wouldn't mind if this were a little thicker. But they seem to be generally punching out well. Quality seems good. No issues that I can see so far. So all that is good stuff. And this is pretty much more of the same, so I'm not going to crack into this. Let's have a look at what's happening in here. So these look like the epic structures or buildings that the game, the rule book was probably referencing. I gotta say, it looks pretty clean in terms of how it's laid out in here. Now, the structure of the components, the quality of the components themselves is quite decent. I mean, these are thick, chunky wooden pieces, so that's good. Design seems to be clean. Generally, it looks like you can distinguish them well enough. But again, once all of these are out on the board, I'm not sure how easy or difficult it might be. So maybe you might need a couple of plays to remember which one exactly does what. But that will come with time. But generally, overall, like the look of how this is. And the insert is a nice little thing to have. Now we have another insert over here. And this is the main one by the look of things. So let's crack in here. Now, we got a set of cards, so maybe we'll just, because we already have it out, maybe we'll have a look at this now and see what's happening in here. And there we go. So these look like these correspond to some of the objective cards we had in the base game where you meet the condition and you get the points in question. Cardstock is quite decent. Has a nice little linen finish on it as well. So overall, very happy with how this looks. Of course, from an art work point of view, it's minimal, but it's quite functional. And again, I think they work quite well in the base game itself. So these, though, might be new. I don't remember these being in the base game. So this might be the type of card that's new in the expansion itself. And these look new as well. So I think these are the buildings that we got. So this is recruitment, disrepair, reserves. No, they don't look like buildings. But it's not something that was there in the base game, so I assume that this is new. These I don't remember in the base game, so I assume this is new. These look like just additional cards you can select play with. And these, I mean, cards like these were in the base game, it looks like. So there's some new ones you can work with on it, but it's good to have a nice combination of things that are new and more of the old stuff that you liked and enjoyed. So that's good. Now we have a whole bunch of wooden pieces in here, and these look like they would correspond to individual play colors. We'll maybe just bring a couple of these out and have a quick look. Overall thickness is good. It is nice and chunky. Now, I don't remember whether there's space in... I actually have sort of like the individual player trays that comes in the base game box, and I don't remember if there was space for these separately or not, but we'll figure it out. Of course, if you have the retail version, then you wouldn't need to worry, because that would not be in there. Now, this is a sticker sheet, and I assume that these will go underneath... Move this up a little bit underneath these guys in here. So basically the way that it worked is whenever you defeat these rebels, these would be randomly strewed out. You would just look underneath and you would have a specific benefit that you would get by virtue of defeating those guys. So that's the sticker that you have for that. And these look like they're pretty consistent with what we saw in the base game. If memory serves me correctly, they look More or less the same. They were black as well, seems to be about the same size. And I assume that the mold is, oh, let's get it there. There we go. And I assume that the mold is probably the same too. Quality overall is not bad considering what it is. We get some more wooden resources. So if you had them in the base game, you know what they are all about. Now you do get these miniatures, and I assume these are the three new leaders we get in the base game. Level of detail is good. I have seen a few games where maybe they tend to be a little more detailed, but overall I'm quite happy with these. These are not bad. This is actually quite decent. Yep. Right, so that's this guy right there, and then the last one. Let's see if we can get in a good level of focus. There we go. And then lastly, we have a set of cards. So we're gonna crack into this and see what we have inside this one. Right. And looking at the card set, we can see these are possibly the new building cards that we had the game come with. So it looks like this is the siege tower. These are the catacombs. We have the border fort and logging camp. And they definitely have a nice colorful art book on the back. So that's there. Again, stock quality on these is pretty decent as well. Somewhat similar to what we saw in the smaller cards. These, I assume, are the new leaders the game comes with. So we have Glek, Theophana, and, well, that's not a leader. We have Armed Uprising. Not sure what this one does, but there we go. We have Round Summary. Some sort of a reference card. I don't remember this capturing group. So these might be just for the expansion itself. Now we have more cards, and I think we have some more buildings. Yep, and they do have a similar artwork. So we have the cathedral, we have Vice, city state, palace. We have one more card for Theophana and one more card for Glek. Huh. Not sure what's happening there. We have Pagan Unrest. And they are different. These are numbered differently, so it might just be variable in terms of how that works out. We get more cards for capturing troops. We get more building cards. We get a town hall, capital port, library. Then we get, I apologize, I'm pretty sure I'm going to get this wrong. It's Sviatoslav or something like that. Maria. Then we get the mutant Peasant Mutiny, and we get another reference card of sorts. So a whole bunch of cards for you to work with on that front. Overall, definitely it's not, doesn't feel like an expansion that changes the game significantly. Feels more like, you know, you get smaller modules that you can almost like plug in, and varies the gameplay up a little bit. But I'm not really sure how much of them are plug and play. I mean, I assume some of these are probably, you can just choose the heroes that you're working with. But I don't know how much optional some of the other components are. But that's everything that we got in the box for Rurik, Stone, and Blade. Overall, very happy with what's inside. And yeah, looking forward to trying it out pretty soon. I have a whole bunch of other tutorial videos going out pretty soon. A few which I had promised earlier on, which I haven't been able to get to yet, but I will have those out, including the Ankh, which is sort of like one of the major ones I've worked on in the last couple of days. So keep an eye for that. And if you're into similar unboxings or other tutorials, we have more of these coming in the upcoming few days. So stay tuned. Subscribe to the channel if you want to be notified whenever those come up. And in the meanwhile, thanks for watching. I'll see you at the next one. Take care.